Creating a Datadog dashboard is easy, but creating a dashboard that genuinely helps during a crisis takes some skill. Ask yourself, are your dashboards truly useful when it matters most? In this video, I'll walk you through building effective Datadog dashboards and share essential best practices to ensure your dashboards deliver clear, actionable insights during critical moments. First, let's quickly define what a good dashboard looks like and identify key criteria for evaluating its quality at a glance. The primary goal of a great dashboard is to offer a clear, actionable overview of your system's health at a glance. Imagine you're responding to a critical outage. How quickly could your current dashboard help pinpoint the issue? Here's an example of a highly effective dashboard. It integrates service-level objectives, SLOs, critical APM metrics, a clear depiction of system dependencies, and essential infrastructure data. Ideally, your dashboard acts as a single pane of glass, using intuitive color-coded indicators to instantly highlight what's normal and what's problematic, allowing your team to react swiftly and accurately. All right, now let's jump right in and build your first Datadog dashboard. Along the way, I'll also briefly show you how to easily query telemetry data across Datadog. To create your dashboard, navigate to the left-hand menu and click New Dashboard. I recommend using the Main Dashboard option. It's mobile-friendly, adapts to different screens seamlessly, and supports all available widgets. Avoid using screen boards and time boards. These are older formats with limited features. Right now, I already have a dashboard created with a lot of widgets. Now let's enhance our dashboard by adding new widgets. Click Add Widgets in the top right corner. You'll see Datadog offers many visualization options, including time series, top lists, tables, pie charts, and more. Feel free to explore and experiment with these options later to find what best fits your needs. For now, drag and drop a time series widget onto your dashboard. Then we need to edit the graph in the new pop-up. The first section helps you to easily navigate between visualizations in case you have not selected the one of interest. You have plenty of options just from there. So you can test different data visualization in a few clicks and see which one fits you best. Next, let's move to the section dedicated to graphing your data. Here you'll specify exactly which data you want to query. Begin by selecting a data source. Datadog provides telemetry from many products. For our example, we'll stick with metrics and specifically use the system.cpu.idle metric. Now let's narrow down our data using filters. In this case, I'll select our dev environment. Additionally, we can segment our metric using tags. Let's choose the host tag. Previously, the CPU idle metric was an average across all hosts. After applying this tag, we now clearly see the idle CPU value for each individual host separately. Further down, you'll notice Datadog provides many additional customization options, which I'll cover in detail shortly. Finally, there's a section where we can name our graph. Let's title this one CPU idle per host. I can save. The widget is now visible on my dashboard. The other option to add a widget is, if you are interested in something that you've seen in another dashboard, to copy and paste them. Either you can copy with your keyboard, or you go on the top right and click on copy. Go back to your dashboard and paste it. In my case, it was added at the bottom, and we are done for this quick intro. As you could see, it was very simple to create your first dashboard. As you've seen, setting up your first dashboard is straightforward. Although it now contains useful data, it's still somewhat disorganized. Enhancing its clarity by adding context and structure will make it more effective. Let's explore how you can incorporate metadata, create helpful links between dashboards, and follow simple layout tips to significantly boost usability. Having numerous widgets doesn't automatically make your dashboard useful. Right now, there's plenty of information scattered around, but it lacks a clear narrative. It's essential to include an informative title, assign relevant teams, and add a concise description. These simple additions quickly communicate the dashboard's purpose to anyone viewing it. To further improve clarity, let's introduce notes, special widgets in Datadog that support markdown formatting. I'll begin by adding a clear title to my Dataiker dashboard, setting a gray background for better visibility, and saving the changes. Now let's rearrange some widgets to create better structure. Excellent. Our dashboard is now gaining structure, making its purpose clearer to new visitors. Since notes support Markdown, we can also easily include links to external resources. Remember, a single dashboard is rarely sufficient for thorough troubleshooting. Adding helpful links to related pages or other dashboards significantly enhances navigation and usability. You can also conveniently link to other dashboards. These dashboard links appear distinctly, making them easily recognizable. For example, if you'd like to reference my previous dashboard, just copy its link and paste it into a note. Datadog automatically creates a helpful shortcut. I'll keep the note's background gray for this demonstration, ensuring it stands out clearly. Let's add the title as well so it makes more sense. We now have a first level of structure. However, the rest of the widgets are still a bit disorganized, and adding more widgets will break my layout. The tip here is to add a widget called Group. First, let's create a group called Kubernetes, since I have some related telemetry data. I'll use gray as the background color to represent backend metrics. Now I'll add another group named Infra by simply copying and pasting. I'll then gather all Kubernetes widgets and neatly place them within this new group. Now I have a first level of structure, so my dashboard starts to make more sense. I can move my first row, including the title on top. Everything looks a lot clearer. Now I'll add infrastructure-related widgets to their appropriate group. Some of the widgets are about requests, error rate, and latency, so I'll add another section similar to what I've done before. I'll call this new group Red Metrics. Red standing for rate, requests per second, errors, failed requests, and duration, latency. I'll choose purple as the color for the red metrics group. Next, let's reposition widgets into their new sections. Latency hits and requests by service go here. The error count for a different application could ideally be in its own dedicated group for clearer distinction. In just a few minutes, we've significantly improved our dashboard's organization. We now clearly separate application metrics, infrastructure details, and Kubernetes data, all neatly structured within one unified dashboard. Of course, we could continue adding widgets to cover additional dependencies, but even at this stage, the dashboard's purpose is clear. Anyone viewing this dashboard will quickly grasp its intent and easily navigate through the information provided. Next, let's enhance our dashboard by adding variables. Variables let you reuse a single dashboard across multiple contexts. For example, instead of creating separate dashboards for prod and dev, you can easily switch between environments using a variable. Now we've built a clear, understandable dashboard, complete with notes and helpful links. But what if we could extend this further, making the same dashboard easily reusable across different clusters, environments, or teams? You might recall that when querying a metric, we specify filters to narrow down our results. Right now, our dashboard filters specifically for the dev environment and groups metrics by version. But what if we adjusted it so you could effortlessly switch between multiple environments? This is exactly where template variables come into play. At the top of the dashboard, I'll add a new template variable called env. Then I can select which widgets it applies to. Maybe just a few key widgets. Or you can even select all of them at once, depending on your needs. What's the benefit of doing this? Now I have a new dynamic filter, $env, directly tied to our template variable. I can remove the existing static env filters, ensuring the dashboard dynamically updates based solely on the template variable. I could repeat this process for all widgets, ensuring the environment filter is controlled centrally by our template variable rather than individual widget settings. Now, if I choose dev from the template variable, nothing visibly changes since only dev currently has data. Selecting prod won't display any data right now because prod isn't reporting at the moment. Although prod isn't showing data currently, once it starts reporting, you'll easily switch between environments with a single click. This standardizes your dashboards. Another common scenario for template variables is toggling between clusters or different services. I'll illustrate this with another quick example. Consider this widget showing the hit rate for a single service. First, let's duplicate it. Next, remove the existing service filter and group results by service. Now, we clearly see metrics for two services, front-end and product catalog. Let's create another template variable named service. While this particular example might not be critical for this dashboard, it clearly demonstrates the underlying principle. There's another easy way to apply our new template variable. If I click Edit, I can directly assign the template variable to the widget. When you select the widget, you'll now see our variable automatically included. Let's move this widget to the top to keep things organized and clear. Currently, we have request data for two services, front-end and product catalog. Now, if I choose front-end from our template variable, the metrics for product catalog disappear. Similarly, selecting product catalog instantly updates the widget, showing only that service's metrics. And that's it for variables. I strongly encourage you to frequently use template variables to make your dashboards more flexible and powerful. You'll often find template variables already included in Datadog's built-in dashboards. Here's an example, dashboard focused specifically on service monitoring. Now let's examine the Kubernetes dashboard to illustrate just how extensively template variables are utilized. You can access this dashboard directly from Datadog's built-in dashboard library. Let's switch over to the detailed view to take a closer look. At the top of this dashboard, you'll notice several template variables. These allow you to filter your view by clusters, namespaces, and specific deployments. As you select different filters, the metrics automatically update, making the dashboard adaptable and valuable across any cluster. At this point, our dashboards have become highly impactful and already meet most of your operational and business needs. However, to further enhance readability, there's one more essential feature we should explore: adding meaningful color coding. Now, we've created a structured and context-rich dashboard, but it still lacks visual cues through effective color coding. Currently, it's difficult to immediately know whether metrics indicate normal operation or potential issues. Only this single widget provides limited color information. Let me demonstrate how Datadog's visualization features address this problem. We'll use the hits metric as an example, starting by duplicating the existing widget. Currently, the metric fluctuates up and down without context. But are these changes normal or do they signal an issue? Right now, we can't tell. A great solution is to add the same metric again but apply a transformation. I'll duplicate the original query and then add a time shift function. Typically, you'd compare current metrics to historical data from 1 week or 1 month ago. For this demonstration, I'll shift the data by just 1 hour, since my available data history is limited. To clearly distinguish the two datasets, I'll set the style of the historical data to a dashed line. This instantly helps us differentiate between current performance and past trends. Here we see performance was fairly consistent, but in this section there's a noticeable drop compared to the previous period. Now the graph provides valuable context about the metric's behavior. For more advanced comparisons, Datadog also offers built-in machine learning algorithms. If you click Add function, you'll see several options, such as outliers, anomaly detection, forecasts, and even one specifically for cloud cost forecasting. The outlier function identifies metrics behaving differently from others. For example, it quickly highlights if a single host is performing unusually compared to its peers. The anomaly detection algorithm defines a normal range based on historical patterns. It clearly shows whether your current metrics fall within or outside expected values. The forecast algorithm predicts future metric values based on historical trends. This feature is especially helpful for capacity planning, allowing you to anticipate when resources like memory or credits might run low. In this example, my data has cyclical patterns depending on time, so I'll select the agile algorithm. The bound setting determines the sensitivity. Setting it to 6 creates broader boundaries, while 1 creates stricter, narrower limits. Both robust and agile algorithms handle cyclical data well. You can refer to Datadog's documentation for details on how they differ and when to use each. Right now, there isn't enough historical data for the algorithm to define a normal range, since my environment just started reporting metrics recently. If I go to the past day, it is mostly empty. So the algorithm cannot figure out what is the norm and what is expected from the metric. Once enough data accumulates, a gray band indicating normal behavior will appear. Another visual insight approach is setting explicit thresholds, like we previously did with error rates. Thresholds immediately signal if metrics like latency are within acceptable limits. For instance, if our graph displays latency metrics, P50, P75, P90, P95, I want them all below a certain threshold. Using the markers option, I can add a line or shaded band. Personally, I prefer a band for improved visibility. So I can go to markers. Here we can put a line or a range. Initially, let's set our threshold at 0.5, or perhaps even lower at 0.3. Now, with this visual marker, it's immediately clear that all the values exceed this threshold, shown clearly in red. Let's try adjusting the threshold higher. Since these values might actually be displayed in minutes, we should probably increase our threshold to 60 seconds to make it more realistic. The story is not completely different. Now the situation looks much better. Most values stay within our acceptable limits. We did have a single spike that approached the threshold, but if we increased it further, say to 600, even that spike would no longer appear problematic. This lets us quickly recognize normal behavior and confidently move on to other areas. With this visual clarity, we can instantly identify potential issues without needing to carefully read the titles or labels. You can apply this same visual principle across most Datadog widgets. Always use visual formatting whenever possible. It significantly speeds up dashboard readability and immediately highlights critical issues. For example, if I set a threshold of -1 in another graph, everything would instantly show up in red, clearly indicating an abnormal condition. The ultimate goal of using effective color coding is rapid readability. Imagine yourself being paged at 3 a.m. after already having a long and exhausting week. How much faster and more efficient would you be if your dashboard clearly showed you exactly what's going wrong at a single glance? You've now learned the essential principles behind creating truly effective Datadog dashboards. Dashboards that provide immediate insights, clarity, and actionable information when you need it most. Remember, a great dashboard tells a story, structures information clearly, uses visual cues intelligently, and leverages template variables for maximum flexibility. If you found this helpful, subscribe to our channel for more Datadog tips, tutorials, and best practices. For further assistance, explore our other in-depth tutorials. Thanks so much for watching, and as always, happy monitoring!